I think sports fans by now are familiar with the concept of the NBA bubble. Remember that? For the end of last season. The Cowboys here at training camp in Oxnard, this is a bubble too, and they've downplayed this. The league has. They haven't called it that exactly. They haven't framed it that way exactly, but that is exactly what it is. And we're going to take a little tour of the Cowboys Oxnard bubble to give you an understanding of that. There is still a VIP area, and if you're a VIP, Cowboy players, families, politicians, I don't know, Kevin Costner, you get to be there in that section, okay? You do not get to go down into this section, which is where fans used to congregate, VIP fans and otherwise. That yellow bar that used to separate fans from the media, and then the media, of course, was separated from the field itself. Now the media is going to be backed up a little bit, and this is also bubblicious. There's different levels of media. So if you're a beat writer, you get this super level. There's I think a lot of radio guys that have you don't get to get as close level. And then obviously employees and the rest have a level above this one. Hard Knocks probably have the super level. So there's your VIP area. There's the field, familiar, obviously, to Cowboy fans. You got the two fields. You've got the brick wall over here. Some nice views if you want to go live in those houses over there. You can watch practice from up there. There will be media meetings with players at the end of the 11 a.m. California time workouts, and they'll be over there. Okay, over here, hope you can see it okay, that's where fans will be able to congregate. And again, there's the sideline, then there's the yellow, then there's a fence, and then there's fans. And over there in fans, as you can see, there's fun and frolic and music and a beer garden and the whole thing. So that'll work. Not bad. All right, let's move from VIP and the field. And let's go to the, what we just call the tennis courts. Okay, and here you see different radio station setups. The brilliance of these guys, of course.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Of course. Radio, radio, radio. There is the assistant programming king of 105 Through the Fan, Tim Collins. There he is. And as you can see, 105 Through the Fan has the primo spot. We have the premium spot when it comes to the Glory Hole press conference, which is coming up today at 10 o'clock. Pacific time. We've got super tables, we've got super space. There's the Ted Nichols Payne array of junk. There's what I believe to be the Sean Sharif stolen Keurig from the hotel. There is the setup for the microphones. You see the Steven, you see the McCarthy, you see the Jerry. And then the fourth one maybe is the Dalrymple, so he can tell Jerry after he says glory hole to stop it. There is the print media tent over there. Now, more VIP junk, of course, decorated very cleverly and craftily in the silver and blue with the turf for no particular reason. More VIP stuff, and actually, So this is where we used to be able to walk in, especially if you kind of were a little pushy or had a little hookup. Just march right in here and out to the field you go. This will not be accessible this year this way. And you can see some of the modern technology that the Cowboys use, everything from that thing to now, the modern technology of the nets and the always modern technology of the toilets. there in the distance is the hardworking Jane Slater. Hi, Jane Slater. Lovely and talented Jane Slater. Here's the field. If they see me walking on this, they will probably kick me off. All right. That's Jane Slater's, and that's probably her camera crew set up over there for NFL Network. All right, let's see if we can't pull off one final thing that I think you'll find cool, because ultimately it's not about the VIP. Oh, I forgot one VIP cool thing. Ultimately, it's not about the VIPs, ultimately, right? It's not about the media, ultimately, as self-important as we often are. But that's not bad. Go get yourself go get yourself a VIP movie seat chair. That's not bad. Let's try one of those. Yeah, that's a pretty good way to watch practice. Let's get it right there. Put your coldie right there. And you're raring to go. Okay, now, one final thing that I think you will find intriguing. And again, we are in the bubble, and this is a first. They didn't term it that way last year. And again, we didn't come to Oxnard. There was the limited number of people at the Star, of course. And it was bubblicious, but this one, this really is the term that's being used here. Here's the NFL Films guys. All right, now back here. And once again, we'll see how far we go before somebody tackles me and say, Fisher, get your ass out of here. Okay, here we go. There's the weight room. Now again, semi-private business. So, that might be the hardest work of all for the Cowboys staff when they move all this stuff. That's what all these boxes are. That's where all them weights that get lifted, that's where they come from. And then the Cowboys with their, we call them dorm rooms, but obviously actually they're hotel rooms. And they're kind of like a townhouse hotel. Upstairs, downstairs, a little extra space in some of them. Some of them are two-story. And then over there, the Cowboys locker room that leads you down to the weight room. And Cowboy players getting ready to roll, as you can see. So that's the way it works. That's the Cowboys training camp. I would suggest, it's not exactly Hard Knocks quality, my film techniques, but I would suggest to you that is the first look at the Cowboys Oxnard bubble. Fish out.